Welcome back, guys, as we explore another course. Today we are playing West Guth Park, which is in Corpus Christi. This park is just outside of the main town, just a little bit. But before we get started, we're going to do things a little bit different. We're going to have two winners this time for this video. We have two Captain Raptors to give away. All you got to do is make sure you're subscribed to the channel and leave a comment. So here we go. Hole one, par three, 402. This one has the pond right there to the right, but you could try to throw a huge hyzer over the trees. You better have some distance and be brave, because that hole or the cage is pretty close to the water's edge there. Or you can take this sidearm route like I did, or throw something a little flippy, but I was lucky that I crashed into these trees and did not go into the water. But ended up catching one of those branches, but here we are going for the par putt. And I will take that. So moving on, hole two, par three, 332. You're going to have kind of a little gap here that you can hit, or you can go up and over everything. And I tried going up and over everything. And the wind here today was just swirling headwinds, left, right, up, down. It doesn't matter where you're at. It just is all over the place. And it ended up getting pushed down just like that putt did as well. But there we are, another par. So hole three, 404. As you can tell already, that this course is definitely for big arm throwers. If you're playing from the longs, they do have red tees, which are about 2,000 feet shorter if you're playing the 18. This one that we're playing today is their 20 hole layout. They have some extra holes, and we'll get to that a little bit later. But on this one, you know, you have your typical routes. And that's the cool thing about this park, is you definitely have a lot of options. You can throw what you enjoy. Not a ton of OB either. So from here, just almost a 400-foot hole. And to the left is actually a high school. So I know if you're there a little bit later in the day, you can kind of see that's their track right there. So sometimes there'll be some people running. Got to be cautious of that. But other than that, this is, when we were there, a pretty quiet park. So, going in for another par. So, here we are, almost a 500-foot par 3. Quite the distance. There's that school in the background as well. So, just one of those to where you can grip and rip. A lot of trees, you know, to the right and left that aren't, you know, huge factors, but just got to watch out for them. So laying up, added a zone back to my bag. I was having my pyros are just a little overstable. I needed something that was just a little bit straighter flyer for me, so added that back in. So here we are, hole six. I'm going to go up and over everything with an octane. And this one I thought was going to be an ace, just ended up parking right next to the basket. So happy with that. Getting the first birdie for the day. Always a good feeling. I'm sure you guys can all agree with that as well. So hole seven, par three, 532 feet. Now this drive that I'm about to throw, you're actually gonna see it transition. I did ended up not having the layup footage, so please don't think that this is where I landed. I was probably like 100 short, and then this was the layup and the wind just carried it. But this is for par, so another par there. Hole 8, par 3, 315. Got the water there to the left side, so got to watch out for that little ravine. And then, you know, that would probably play out of bounds, of course. So just wanted to throw a sidearm, something stable, end up on top of this hill. And I was just trying to avoid the water that's down there. They didn't have a lot in this area, but there were little patches of it. So hole nine, gonna be going uphill about 255. That where that road is, obviously that's OB. There's water in there as well, so you got to watch out for that. But obviously that's super close, so you guys should be good. Had a decent approach at this and was able to save that one for a birdie. So hole 10 going downhill. This one obviously is one of those ones where you got to shape your shot, or you could go up and over everything. One thing I've noticed is majority of the parks here in Texas, the trees aren't massive. Now there are some parks that have bigger trees, but a lot of times you can just go up and over everything. But I'm sure you guys have all felt this way, to where you're just coming up short on everything. You just want to throw your bag in there, because that's kind of how that putting was today. So here we go, 10A. These are the alternate holes. There's going to be two of them that go back to back. And really not a lot of danger here. Just have the neighborhood, which is to the left. Just could not connect. So taking another par here. Using also my new Flight Factory Judge, if you guys saw that. The custom stamp. That's what they sent out to, or you could select the disc from the team, and rocking my new shirt as well. So pretty pumped about that. But hole B, this is probably one of the ones that has a lot of out of bounds. I like to imagine that the sidewalk is OB and the road's OB. So, or the pylons. I was talking to someone about that when they hold tournaments here, that they will use those pylons as out of bounds as well and draw lines. So obviously that'll make it a little bit harder. So going in for another par. Here is the first par 4, 630 feet. And it'll actually cross over to the other side. So the basket right there to the right. I apologize for that late footage, because I wasn't 100% sure which basket it was. But it is the first one. So if you guys ever do play this course, just know that. So that ravine right there does have some water in it. Be cautious of that. I got really lucky. I ended up catching that tree, but it did kick it left for me, so I was thankful. I just didn't decide to go swimming. And just coming up short on that putt. So taking a par. So hole 12, 220, par 3. These ones on the downhill slope just always get me. I just have a hard time gauging that distance. Or not the distance, but the angle of the slope. Just curious if any of you guys out there do as well. And just that drop-off right there is pretty crazy. So you gotta watch the rollaways. I was a little timid on that putt when I was running it. But here we are. 228. Gonna be throwing the zone this time. Try something with a little less stability than that pyro, and actually worked out for me. So maybe when I'm on the side of a hill, I'll start throwing the zone. Something with a little less stability than the pyros, because those will just go. So hole 14, 247. So road right there, OB, and I'm sure this sidewalk is OB as well. But I did not play it as that today, so I was giving myself a par, don't tell anyone. But I was just sick and tired of those putts that were just coming up short. So here we go, 432 uphill, probably playing closer to 500 in my opinion. Especially when you have the uphill to it. So just throwing my octane, just trying to grip it and rip it as far as I can. So from here, throwing that zone, just a few little guardian trees protecting the basket. But you definitely have entries left or right, or even through the middle there. And my wife was filming today, and this course, you end up walking probably a little over 3 miles, and you got a lot of hills that you got to go up, so she was just filming from down there closer to this next tee. So this was the only one that caught the side of our tripod, so I do apologize for that, but big, big downhill shot. I was able to get across to the other side of that little ravine there and working on this jump putt. And just a little long. And as you guessed it, another par. Those long holes were getting to me. So here we go. Par 3, 242, coming to an end. This one you could obviously throw either one. Whenever I have a short hole, I always prefer going sidearm if it's wide open. I feel more comfortable when I'm gauging the distance. I don't know if any of you guys are like that either. And sinking that birdie. So here we go, hole 18, last hole, 233. Finally nice to have a few short holes that you can definitely get. But on this one as well, just like every other hole, you have plenty of options. And you just kind of throw what's comfortable for you. But this will wrap it up. Hopefully you guys check out the next video.
All right, guys, just got done here at West Guth Park. Hopefully I'm saying that right. In Corpus Christi, this is the actual first 18-hole course that we got to play. It's the only one in this area. If you come to this park, make sure that you enjoy walking and you bring some water, because they utilize the whole entire park. You know, they have two additional holes, 10A and 10B, if you want to play them. If not, hop to 11. But this goes up and down hills all over the park, probably walking a little over 3 miles, maybe be my guess. I know the course is 7,300 feet, if I remember correctly looking at it, but it, minus all that, this is definitely a bomber's course. You gotta have a strong arm out here. You know, some of these are 500 foot par threes, uphill, downhill, you know, so you gotta make sure that you get good distance. But overall, you know, they have some small tee pads as well if you want to play those. But definitely worth the trip. Just make sure, like I said, you're ready to walk. My wife came out here today. She was walking with me. It is my birthday. That's the only reason she's here. If it wasn't for my birthday, I probably would have been doing this by myself. So I'm gonna go treat her to some drinks now. But hopefully you guys enjoyed this park. As always, subscribe and like the channel. Take care.